Okay, so far what we have seen is basically some basic data types. The basic data types were Boolean, which had true and false values, integers, which had negative, zero or positive values, and the character data type. And we saw subtypes of this, various subtypes of this, and then we made this data type called strings, which was a sequence of characters, and then we saw a lot of subtypes of the strings data type. Now I am going to introduce two more complex or some ways of putting together all these data types together in a kind of a package or a bundle. Okay. So there are two ways of bundling, and one way of bundling is what is called a record. So sometimes in some programming languages it is called struct, right? In C and C++ it is called struct, or sometimes it might be called a class, right? Or it might, in mathematics we like to call it a tuple, right? But record basically is just a data set, or a basically a data item which has a number of elements, and these elements are called fields, right? So for example, we saw the marks card. So if you look at a marks card, what I have shown in the figure here, it had basically this number 9, which is the sequence number. It had a name, it had a gender, it had a date of birth, city, and the various marks. So this has these fields, right? These are the fields of this marks card. So how do we represent the entire marks card as one data item, right? What, how do you represent, what is the data type of this marks card? So the value, that the valid values, the range of values, or the valid values that the marks card can take is not, cannot be, you know, you cannot write it down independent of the values that the fields can take, right? So you are basically trying to define what are the fields in this particular data item and what are the values that the fields can take. So it is enough to basically write down all the fields and the data types of those fields, and that is what I have attempted to do for this particular card. So if you recall, we had the sequence number, and we have already defined the correct type of data type for sequence number, which was CQNO. So I can write sequence number is sequence number data type, name is of the names data type, gender is of the gender data type, date of birth is of the dates data type, city is of the city data type, and these marks are of the marks data type. Okay. So basically the marks card is a record, right? It is a record data type which contains various fields, and each of these fields has a specific data type. So the values for each of these fields is constrained by the kind of data type that you are defining for that particular field. So the sanity of this card, right, the marks card, is ensured because you have defined the fields data types, right? So that is how the sanity is ensured. Now you can look at the second data type that we had, which is the words, which are words in the paragraph that we had. For example, we had this word called it, which is a pronoun. It had two letters and we had the sequence number 0. So there are clearly 1, 2, 3, 4 fields in this data type. This is a record with 4 fields, and what are those 4 fields? Sequence number is obviously of sequence number type. The word, which is in the card, is of the words data type. The category, which is pronoun, preposition and so on, is of the category data type, and the letter count is of a count data type. Okay. So we have already defined the subtypes that we need for writing the data type for all the fields in this card. Finally, if you look at the set of all the marks cards, right? If I had the bunch of all the marks cards, is there a data type that can basically that can represent that? Now, because I can write for one card, I can write a record, but for the entire set of cards, I need something else. So sequence of data elements, right, is called a list. So you can make a list, which list is basically just a sequence of, just like a string basically was a sequence of characters, so a string is also in principle a list. So the sequence of data elements is a list, for example, a sequence of records. So a marks card list is just a sequence of marks card record data types. A paragraph word list is just a sequence of word in para record data type. So the list, the set of all the marks cards is a marks card list. The set of all the words in the paragraph is a paragraph word list. And similarly, the set of all shopping bills is a shopping bill list. Of course, I have not told you what the record data type for the shopping bill is. So let's look at that. Okay. How do we do the record for the shopping bill? Now, if you look at a shopping bill, again, it looks like you have the name of the shop, you have the name of the customer, you have a sequence number, and you have a total amount. Besides that, you also have a list of items. Now, the complication comes because of this list of items, right? This is a name, this is also a name, this is a sequence number, and this is an amount. So, all of these I can capture, but this again, I do not know how many items will be there in this list. So, let me take a first pass at making this record. So, I have the sequence number, which is sequence number data type, store name, which is a name data type, customer name, which is a name data type, total bill value, which is an amount data type, and then there are items in the shopping bill whose data type I do not know how to define. Why do not I know how to define? Because I do not know how many, there may be many elements in it, that is why I do not know how to define it. But it looks like, because there are a sequence of elements there, it looks like it is a list. So, something like a list should be put here. Now, when you say list, it has to be a list of something. So, what is it a list of? It has to be a list of these items, right? One row is an item. We have a list of such items. So, if you take one item and make a record data type out of it, then it will be a list of that record, okay. So, what does one item look like? It has basically the item name, it has a category name, it has quantity, it has price, and it has the cost. So, I can try and define the data type for that. So, I have the item name, which is of the name data type, item category, which is a string data type, quantity, which is quantity data type, unit price, which is an amount, and cost, which is also an amount. And once I have defined a data type for an item, then I can go back here and fill this as a list of items. Item list is just a list of item data type. So, that, so in this way I have basically created a record data type for shopping bill. So, note that a record data type for shopping bill contains a number of fields. One of those fields is a list. That list basically is a list of records. So, basically it is a record of a list which contains a field which is a list of another record, which is item, which in turn has a number of fields, okay. So, it is a little bit more involved data type, and as we go along we will be seeing such a hierarchy of data types that we can build, which is basically putting together basic data types to create more, you know, complex data types, then working through those complex data types to do solving our problems, okay. So, to summarize, a data type defines values that a variable can take and the set of operations that are permitted on it. The basic data types that we saw were integer, boolean and character. That is what we saw for our data sets, that what we needed for our data sets. The subtypes of a type basically are used to further restrict the values or operations that can be performed on the data type. A record type is a collection of named fields. Each of those fields may have the same or could be different data types, right. For example, when we saw the marks card data type, it had basically different fields. All the fields had very different values, but the marks, if you look physics, maths, chemistry and total marks, they were all of the same data type, but all the other fields, name and date and all, had different other types of data types. But list, if you take the list data type, typically the data types, the data type of all the elements in the list are usually the same, because it is not necessary. You could also make a list of different data types, but usually most of the times we will see lists in which all the elements in the list are all of the same data type. So, list is just a sequence of elements, all of which have the same data type, okay. So, with that we end this lecture on data types and how to use the data types to constrain the values and to constrain the operations that can be performed on them.